Let's see. He's wearing plus one. She's wearing plus one. Lindsay's wearing plus one. Rove gets nothing. All right. Well, everybody's going to have magic armor at the very least, and probably also magic weapons. And we still made a little bit of money on that. Very nice. I'm incredibly pleased with that. Go ahead and equip that. And we will throw the scimitar on Cambly. Nice plus nine to hit there. Can appreciate that. She's only at a plus six. Oh, because she's power attacking. And it goes even lower when she's cleave. Well, no, cleave drops her AC. Never mind. Amory doesn't care. She just needs to hit once. Let's go pester Keston and let him know that we killed his gnome. Hey, Keston. Let's see. Keston, I'm sorry I failed to capture Tartuccio alive. He attacked me and was killed brutally.
Well, this is not the best outcome, but I think it will be good enough for Jamandi. Take this as a reward for your help. I'll send word to Restov and let them consider how they might return the favor. Once again, I thank you for your help. I'll remain here until my men recover from their wounds. Meanwhile, we'll help guard the trading post and fight off any bandits should they return. Good luck in all your plans and endeavors.
Keston, you're a bro. I will see you later. Farewell. Okay, we're gonna rest. Because Jesus. Gotta invest in the future. Come across 15 more barbarians that need plate armor. Maybe. Who knows? We can't have them running around too fast, right? Should have had disintegrate scrolls. Nah, Billy. You're thinking too simple, like, with your clever enemy corpse disposal. What you gotta do is I think it's in 3.5. The book, I think, was called Sandburn. Sandstorm? The desert splat book they released. Anyways, there's a spell in there called Flesh to Salt, right? So you turn your enemies into salt, and then you sell them. Because it turns out salt's actually also kind of valuable. Yeah. I'd be lying if I said I'd never done that. It works. That or you do, like, flesh to stone and then rock to mud. That's another good one. Okay, so can I actually, like... Is this... Alright, here's the Stag Lord's Fort, so we actually know how to get there. Oh, wow, it only blopped out this little passage, so I guess that is the... That is, like, the only place we can go. I'm feeling a little railroaded here, jeez. Not really. Exactly, Billy, exactly. Like, the only way to res somebody like that without needing to throw, like, regenerate on them afterwards is it's like a true regenerate or a true resurrection spell would bring them back. But yeah. Jesus, random encounters! Oh, we've been spotted. Here come the Elder Fire Elementals again. I should actually, like, probably be fighting these. Oh, it's just freaking kobolds. Alchemist and a Flame Shaman. I was like, normally if it's a short duration, I'm not going to want to fight it because it's just a waste of resources. But chances are we're going to get a chance to rest here. So yeah, I should be fighting these. Here, we'll even have Rove. Throw some fiery death. Get in there, Amory. Fuck that caster up. Oh, I love it. I want to marry that freaking barbarian. Jesus Christ, she's so nasty. Fuck. And we got some gold and a scroll. Another scroll of Hurricane Bow. Do I have anybody? Okay, so Lindsay can cast it. I don't know if it's actually a bard spell or if she's just use magic devicing it. But like, this would be a good spell for her because it's going to up her damage. Her crossbow will be going from, like, I think she's like a D8 to, what would that be, 2D6. Check crossbows, they occasionally have masterwork stuff. Oh crap, I did not know that. Yeah, holy shit! Thank you for letting me know about that, Billy. I would have just been passing up on this stuff and missing out on my gold pieces. Well, I can rest at any point on overland travel, but at this current juncture, I'm kind of tight on time, and I want to be able to take my time with the Staglord Fortress. Call the essence of salt from the target. Oh, there it is. There it is. Flesh to salt, man. It's a great spell. That and, God, what was it? There was another one that I used to use for corpse disposal, but I can't remember what it was. I don't think we can go back and fight this guy, sadly. That's okay. Freaking mages, man, not even once. Not even once. Belts of anti-magic field. I just make fighters in my games into absolute killing machines, so on the off chance that a wizard gets near enough to one to cast spells, they're probably already dead. They just don't know it. Okay, how's initiative looking? Who rolled good? Luana and Aaron actually rolled pretty well. Aaron, you're gonna charge. Oh, it's just a bunch of alchemists. All right. Oh, but it's out of range. All right, we're just gonna do this. Rove didn't even have a chance to get his burning arc. Wow, one damage. That is Matt. Ooh, 19 damage. Amory, D12 plus 11. She rolled well. Like crossbows. Nothing good this time, it looks like. Alas. Well, yeah, that's exactly it. It's like, basically any character in tabletop, by the time you're in the double digit levels, you're like legendarily powerful. So, yeah, Tome of Battle did a lot to kind of even the playing fields with fighter types. Definitely. And for Pathfinder, God, what was it called? Path of War, which is like the Pathfinder version of Tome of Battle, is very much the same. My God, these random encounters are incessant. If they weren't experience points in loot. Well, I mean, at level 10, a 22 strength, you probably have a higher strength than that, if I had to guess. Kobold Alchemist. Wow, you got your, I mean, the Kobold Alchemist drank its constitution mutagen. That's probably why we didn't blow it up all over the frickin'. How much damage did we just do? Okay, so people just kind of hit Wimpy until Amory came in and turned that thing into that nice fine pink mist. Short bow, leather armor. All right. ...580 pages of martial disciplines. Holy shit. Nice. Also, you can just leave the zone. That's fair. Yeah, that's fair. That's something that, like, I need to remember, that I fully admit that I am forgetting that the game just lets you, you know, if you want to, you can skip corpses. Alright, so I just want to get to this next node. Alright.
Adventures can wait.
Alright, guys, it's nap time, don't worry. No using rations. We have to conserve those for the dungeons. Wow, look at that. Everything even went well. It's like the game's throwing me a bone here or something. And then we get ambushed by trolls in the night. No, we get ambushed by a quick save. That's what happens. But, yeah, like, the Chad Lord. Oh my God. I have heard tales of this fight, Billy. I have heard tales. I'm curious to see how it goes for us. But yeah, in my games, I offer two things for players with regards to the martial versus caster disparity. If you want to play like a fighter, you just play my revised version of the class, which is an absolute juggernaut. Or you play Tome of Battle. Because otherwise you're just going to have a bad time. And it works pretty well. But like, my fighters can do some stuff that other games would probably be like, oh my god, that's hilariously overpowered. Like, my fighters, once you hit, like, I think 6th level, you can, as an immediate action, just interrupt a spell. You don't have to make any rolls or anything. It's like, is the caster within, you know, X feet of you? You interrupt their spell. And it works surprisingly well. So I appreciate the zombies. This was a thing in the tabletop game. The Staglord's Fort is actually built on this hill that, like, every day, like, zombies just crawl out of the ground. In tabletop, we actually took this fort over and used it as a base of operations. It was pretty great. Zombies and all. Ancient. I don't know if it's ancient burial grounds. I think it's like a curse or something. I can't recall. I just know that we made use of it. Oh, there was a zombie lord in there. All right. Sure.
Without a doubt.
I'm superior.
Freaking rogue in the background. God, those zombie lords. Aaron. God, Aaron, you fucking suck so much, dude. Aaron, I hate you. And now we have to reload because I don't have any res on me. Freaking garbage tier. Zombie Lords drop masterwork stuff. Yeah, I noticed that it had a... Oh, look, and we even get Aaron in the loading screen. It's like the game is taunting me. I just need to remember to have him cast shield. That will do wonders for his survivability. I'm just forgetful. And they're zombie. Yeah, the damage magnet. I don't know why. It always seems like he just gets focused down so bad. Don't like having three melees? Ah, I need a front line. Like, if I didn't have a front line, I'd be freaking out. All right, Aaron. Can shield yourself. What's the duration on that? 3 minutes. All right. Two with defensive talents. That's fair. Still, he's still getting eaten alive. I want to check something really quick, because he should have an AC of like 25 now. 21 seems a little low. No? Huh. I don't know. I don't know why his... I don't know why I had it in my head that his AC was like sitting at like an 18 or a 19 unbuffed. Like shield wall and stuff. I'm gonna be grabbing, God, I think it's called outflank. I'm gonna be picking up one of the teamwork feats on all three of my melees. It's the one that grants you like extra attack bonus when you've got like multiple people coordinated outflank. All right, it is outflank. That's what I thought. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I'm tempted to get the one that gives you like precision damage too, but I don't know if it's worth it. Because it's like not a ton of damage, and by the time that my party would have it, they'd be like 11th level or whatever. And at that point, like an extra D6 or whatever isn't monstrous. You can outflank on ranged. That's ridiculous. Like, the flanking system in this is interesting. I think it's something that... I don't know, because, like, I'm of two minds. Like, it makes some class... Some stuff that wouldn't be great in pen and paper really useful. Like, it makes rogues suck a whole lot less, which is nice. But at the same time... Seriously, Amory, I know your AC isn't shit. You knock that crap off. Cambly channel. Some heals flowing here. They're just zombies, guys. I want to see, once this is over, I want to see what these things' attack modifiers are. I'm getting twitchy. Hey, we got +4! That's like proper zombie stats. They must just be rolling well. I am appreciative of all the masterwork scimitars that they're throwing at me, though. And random 700 gold pieces. Sure. and some other goodies. Oh, definitely sell, like, take Command Undead or whatever. Oh, yeah. Go ham on this. All right, Lindsay, squeak some heels out. Because I don't use her spells for anything else.
I'm listening. Together we stand.
I fully expect to camp before we fight the Stag Lord. At least I hope to. Alden Warrior's dog tag. All of this stuff, like all these like golden backgrounded items, we'll get a use out of those once we get our Barony down.
Without a doubt.
Lindsay sucks butts. Ah. Tristian? I don't need some wizard cleric floating around in my back row. I have Cambly. My cleric kicks ass. I don't need some pretty boy in my party. That's what Amory's for. Chibi waifu, oh my god. Some freaking Philistines down there chewing on a corpse by the look of things. Oh no, we've aggroed the cat dogs! Wow. Lindsay just exploded one of them with a crossbow. That's pretty impressive. Amory is best waifu. Like, it makes me... They were actually, from what I understand, going to have a romance with her in this, but Paizo told them no, which makes me incredibly sad, because I like her character a lot in this game. And that's speaking as somebody that, generally speaking, completely ignores romances in RPGs like this. Okay, so I want to come up here and see what's up here, and I assume that this is Sadnessville right over there, so we'll deal with that eventually. How are we looking? Ah, so far. Fifth level just seems so far away. Yeah, that's basically where I stand on it too, Billy, is like they just, they don't do anything for me. It's like, all right, you want your in-game waifu, sure. You can have your three conversations with them and that's all that happens. Unless it's a BioWare, in which case you get like some super soft core imagery and that's it. I don't know. I'm not gonna judge, they're just not for me. Oh, there was a damaged wall up there. Oh, yeah. I suppose we could poke at that. Although the idea of just barging in through the front gate... Oh, the gate! Oh, the gate's not closed. We will investigate. Let's check out the damaged wall. A lot of stuff to notice with Tab. I mostly forget that it highlights, like... stuff that you can do like this with, like athletics and stuff. And I'm just like, it highlights loot. I care about loot. Must have it on at all times. Let's see, athletics or mobility? Climb over the wall or broaden it by force? Is this a single character doing these or is this party-wide? Because athletics, we have a 7? Yeah. And mobility, we have absolute hot trash. All right, Aaron.
I'm always ready.
Go ahead and run that passage, please.
Failure.
Oh, I heard him say, what a failure. Climbing over the breach proved more difficult than it seemed, judging by the voices coming from the fort. We've been spotted. Uh-oh.
Who dares disturb me while I'm drinking?
Oh, is that a Kyros there? The dude with the sword and board? Alright, well, the fight is... Whoa. That's kind of nifty. They go with, like, the painted background for over cliffs. I kind of like that. Huh. Kind of jarring, but not bad.
I stand ready.
Okay. I should, like, at some point throw mobility, like, on some character. I'll have to take a look. Probably Luana, if I had to guess. Oh, she's actually leveling it. She's just, oh, we have encumbrance. That's why her mobility is so bad. Yeah, we have medium encumbrance. That'll do it. Horse. Gonna get the hard mode? Of course I am. And it's raining. So I think that actually has effects on thing in this. I did not mean. Let's not. Oh, they're below us. All right, what do we got? Brawler, Bard, Alchemist. Of them, I'm gonna say the most dangerous is actually probably that Alchemist, because AoE? My temptation is to just... I'm gonna do it. Amory, get in there. Oh god, she can't. The spell is flawed. One of these days, I'm gonna roll a caster Amory, and everything's gonna be terrible. This is just immediately pear-shaped, by the way. Like, we haven't had a chance to buff. We have nothing. This is gonna be bad. I love it. Is she one-handing that axe? Amory, I love it. This won't kill me, immediately dies. I don't even know what murdered her.
Forgive me for this failure.
I don't even know that the berserker is what killed her. I have no idea. Is he? No, yeah, it was the brawler. 24 damage with a greatsword. 2d6 plus 15. That seems maybe a little bit excessive. I don't know. Because, I mean, Amory's doing plus 11. Eh, I don't know. Maybe that's appropriate. I've done the math on things that seemed off before, and, like, it came out right, so I don't know. I don't even know what's going on here. My front row is down. Amory's dead, so we're just going to go ahead and reload. Was my last autosave seriously before we even came in here? That seems wrong. I could have sworn I'd saved multiple times in here. Huh. All right. Yeah, like, I've read a lot of people bitching about the encounter balance in this, but based on what I've seen and actually, like, mathed out, things have been more or less on point. Mostly. Close enough that I'm not going to, like, throw a shit fit about it. Throwing down with primal manticores. Alright. That sounds like a thing. Man, this chaps my ass. How did I not quicksave at any point during this? I could have sworn that I quicksaved right outside this fucking gate. My vittles are officially chapped. I don't know. Oh man, those fire elementals. Like, that elder fire elemental encounter, that hit me, and I wasn't even mad because that's like some first edition bullshit right there. Like, oh! You're adventuring in the mountains! Teehee, let me roll on the random encounter chart. And, you know, 90% of it's like, here's a couple orcs. Maybe some goblins, an ogre, or a hill giant. And then there's that one. There's that one note on there that's like 1d4 plus 1 beholders. And that right there, I love it. Like, it's just so dumb that, like, I can't even be mad. It's just like, nah, the game just hates me, whatever. Killer DM. Amory, what are you doing? Come on, girl. Amory! Oh, AI, never change. Alright, I just need one of you guys. I just need one of you to go down there and loot the body, not the whole party. Yeah, I did find the weir rats, Billy, and it ended predictably. Yeah, those weir rats, that was... Nighthammer told me that there's actually some pretty good gear in there, But I don't know how anyone would be expected to survive that at first level. Where is Aaron? Aaron was like outside in the darkness. He's a special boy. I think this next time we're just gonna knock on the front door, try to parlay with him, and then stab him in the head. Fully buffed, of course.
Without a doubt.
Won't be that till level 5 or so, yeah. Well, I mean, I got in there, and I'm like, okay, it's just some weird rats. Alright. Game quick saved. Alright, making sure it actually saved this time. I got in there, and I'm like, oh, it's just weird rats. Weird rats are like, you know, CR1 or whatever. Speaking of which, I had somebody ask me to explain what CR is. CR is challenge rating. And the way it works, at least in 3rd edition in Pathfinder, is that, like, an enemy of CR whatever is a appropriate challenge for a party of CR whatever. So, like, one challenge rating, one creature is an appropriate encounter for 4 first level characters. It's not always correct, but it is what it is. Anyways. Yeah, I don't know, like, what low-level party is gonna go in there. Because, yeah, okay, weird rats, sure. I've got 6 guys. Throw 3 weird rats at me. And then it's like, oh wait, no. No, you silly ass. These aren't weird rats. These are all weird rats with rogue levels. And there's alchemists. And by the way, we hate you. And it's just like, come on. And for whatever reason, Cam, we didn't just cast Bless there. I got nothing. Yeah, those weird rats are like just legit no joke. There goes Amory. She's not dead though, so we'll just heal after combat. Aaron just standing down here all confused like, not doing anything of import. Oh man. Exactly, Marble. That is generally the way to look at it. It's a rough guideline. It's like how hit die were in older editions. Is you just gotta ballpark it and know what your party's capable of. There. See what level? It can't be 3rd level. Yeah, that he is just rolling really badly for the heals on his channeling energy, and it's beginning to irk me. I don't know. Alright, I want him to just aggro everybody before the rest of the party gets in on this. Amory, you are a monster. Those cleaves! I love it. It's destroying her AC, but it doesn't matter because she's destroying everything else. Oh, never mind. Down she goes again! Amory tanking the floor. That damn crab. That damn crab, like the one in fucking... God, what was that? See, there was a crab in... Was it White Plume Mountain that had the crab in it? I think, way back in the day, the giant crab. I think it was like guarding that intelligent trident or whatever. Wave.
What troubles you?
Okay, we gotta heal, because idiocy happened. Okay. I could have Can We Blow spells on healing. And I guess I will have him blow one. Just one. That's all you get, Aaron. I'm not spoon feeding you any more hit points after this. And we've looted all of this stuff. Oy. And I believe there was a thing over here, yes. Okay, I think that was everything. So now, as any proper sieging force, we will camp outside their front gate and then attack. What's your take on healing in here? I mean, it's the same as in tabletop. If you're doing it during combat, shit's going and you're probably fucked. Post-combat healing is post-combat healing. Okay, so we're gonna quick save. I'm not gonna rest. Instead, we're gonna go in fully buffed and see what we can make of this. I wanna at least clear the front gate, if possible.
Ready for anything.